I was just going to start off by asking you, your character sort of, she's spends a lot of her time in the control room, on the radio. Is it a challenge to kind of, you know, keep the action adrenaline going when you're sort of in the room trying to act against almost nothing but just people's voices on the radio?
Yeah, it's a little odd, you know, to kind of be so separate and know that something that, you know, most audience members will experience in an hour and a half is actually, you know, stretched out for months and months and months. And it is pretty odd, but it's an amazing process to be with such incredible people who kind of keep your energy up. I mean, Tony alone is like the incredible, like, gets you going. Like, he's running around. His energy is so infectious. I mean, you meet him and he's just constantly moving and energy, and just like that color pink on his face never goes away because he's always like flushed with excitement and flushed with energy. And, you know, that's the same thing we sort of kind of just gave to Connie, just to make sure that, you know, and for whatever reason, she's lunging for the phone or she's racing over here, she's always slightly out of breath because she's just that earnest and just on top of it. And, you know, so you just kind of make up physicalities for her. Like, we did this thing where I constantly was putting my hair up and taking it back down, you know, so you can kind of see that, you know, if she could, she'd probably be running around the place, but she's just kind of controlling herself. But that kind of twitchiness is just to kind of, it's enough to keep you connected to all of the action shots when you're out of that control room. You know, it's somehow, because of the style of shooting and with that energy we created, we were able to cut between the two, and it never felt like you were suddenly in this train and then lagging in this room. You know, it's something we had to think about a lot, which is, again, so weird because you don't even know what the other people are doing in the other scenes because you're not there.
And so the guys were obviously, you know, on trains, real trains, Tony put them there. Did you ever find yourself going, God, I wish I was out there just, you know, jumping from, you know, truck to truck?
Oh, yeah, absolutely. I mean, I did as much of that as possible with just hanging around on set and kind of driving people crazy. And we did a lot of piggyback rides and hanging out and, you know, whiling, you know, when we were on set and, like, off and just chilling with each other. And you know, it's good to create some kind of energy. And, you know, I'm totally jealous that I didn't get to do much of it on camera, but, you know, off camera we did quite a lot of running around and jumping and ridiculousness, you know, and you have to do a lot to keep yourself warm, you know, when you're in these, like, crazy places. But, you know, it happens that time, you know. I make fun because, you know, even the guys, you know, they sat most of their time in a cab not doing much of anything either. Right. And even when they were doing stuff, you know, sometimes it was a stuntman. So, you know, at least I do my own stunts.
And you have possibly the most iconic line of the movie and possibly of the year with the whole missile the size of a Chrysler building. Was it just fun to deliver that, and did you get to sort of have your take on how you delivered it? Were you just like, I'm going to go for it?
Oh, yeah. No, there's certain lines that you have, you know, Galvin, this is me saving your ass, where you just know it's those, like, beats in a movie that's that line that you get, you know. It's Alien, Sigourney Weaver, get away from her, you bitch! You know, like, there's lines that you just know stand out. Yeah. And, you know, it's like a missile the size of the Chrysler building is, like, such an incredible way of expressing the danger and the phenomenon of this unmanned train being let loose on people. And it really helps you to get the perspective. And it's amazing. It's one of those ones where, you know, that just sums it up. That's going in the trailer, or, you know, that's going to be that magic moment in the movie. And that's the pressure. Because as soon as you know that line's coming up, if I'm aware of it, everybody else is. That's when Tony comes out and he goes, you know, that's the trailer line. Like, you know, it's like the pressure of making sure you hit it right and you say it perfectly. Because otherwise they're going to have to be on somebody else, and that would suck. Yeah, I don't want to mess that line up.
Are you aware it's a line that people are probably going to be quoting back to you in the street? You know, people will be running out going, this is all the size of a Chrysler building! Yeah, I've heard that.
Yeah. You know, it happens. I'm the first one. I get people all the time who come up to me and like, oh, I love Josie and the Pussycats. And I'm like, du jour means family. You know, like, I love those lines that come out of a film. And it's great when you get to have them. Because quite often, you know, I get to be a part of the movie that has that line, but not necessarily always having that keep line. And so it was nice definitely to have a few of those.
I mean, it sounds like you're having fun at the same time.
Good with the boys. No, I had such a good time. Like, I guess I have five uncles on my mom's side alone, you know, and she's an only girl with five brothers. So I think I just have, I'm really good with male energy, but I'm not one of those girls who doesn't like girls. Like, I love my girlfriends and I have that as well, but I can enjoy what the difference is. And it's really amazing to be around just a bunch of guys and you're all just there, and it's a totally different mentality. It's a totally different energy and camaraderie that comes with it. And And I loved it. I had such a good time. And believe me, we have girly moments together too. It's like, don't even get it twisted. But I'll be sitting around and like doing pictures, and you know, I mean, we're usually sticking our middle finger up because it looks cool and tough. But it's still the same. There's still everyone going picture, hanging out with the boys is not always that different from hanging out with the girls.
So then, you've played the game, you've had the sort of briefing from people that have done the situation in real life. If they threw you into a real life yard control system, how do you think you would fare in real life now if they just said, go for it?
I mean, you know, luckily I understand what a collaborative place it is, so I'd rely very heavily on the people around me because, you know, even with learning a lot of what the language is and everything, it literally is a foreign place. It was incredible to do enough research where I could understand what I was supposed to be saying. But it's very technical and it takes a long time. It's a different kind of muscle memory to be working in a place like that. You know, you want to trust your instincts, but they're so out of place in an environment that's so unfamiliar to you that it could be the wrong move, even though it feels instinctually right. So that would be something that I think I have better instincts for it now, but I'd still wouldn't necessarily trust me with your train. Just yet. I don't know. I can wing it. I'll make it look good anyway.